Hey everybody, Daniel Elohim, Daniel Garcia, whatever you want to call me. The channel is Daniel Elohim. Anyway, doesn't matter. I'm talking about the virus outbreak that is happening, the pandemic. It is confirmed in Seattle, California, Illinois, and several states are under watch. Texas, New Mexico. This is big, and it's a virus that spreads before you realize. So if you're a carrier of the virus, or before, as you could have the virus, not know it, and you won't spread the virus until you have symptoms. Now this virus spreads before you have symptoms, so you could be a carrier and spread it before you even show signs that you have it. And it has a up to two week time period before you show signs. So you could have it, and someone could have this virus and potentially spread it 2 weeks before they know it and before they get medical help. Now in China, this seems to be pretty big, and it doesn't seem to be pretty big. It is pretty big in China, and they're not letting us know all the facts through the mainstream media. So if you do some searching around, you can find videos of how panicked they are in China. They are locking down, I think 17 cities is the last that I saw of it this morning. Today's Sunday. I don't know the date, exact date, the end of February, the end of January. They aren't letting people leave these restricted areas. They're going around through the airport and different avenues of transportation with thermometers, checking people's temperature to see if they have it. But by then, if you have a temperature, that means you've already had it X number of days. You might not have a temperature, but still be a carrier of it and spreading this virus around. What I want to tell everyone is use common sense, wash your hands, stay away from fast food, stay away from restaurants, stay away from public places as much as you can. If you do need to go into these places, be aware of your surroundings, people coughing, sneezing. Wash your hands often and thoroughly with water temperature that is going to remove this virus. I don't know the exact temperature. I should have looked that up, but hot water. Make sure you're using hot water and soap. Wash your hands thoroughly. I don't know if antibacterial, when you use the hand sanitizer, I don't know if that's going to be enough. Make sure you wash your hands thoroughly. Use common sense, the common sense that Yahweh, our Father, gave us to use. And don't just go around thinking that you're immune to it, because not everyone is immune to it. No one's immune to it. But God has given us a sound mind, sound body, and we are to use these things to our advantage, and we will not be infected if you're smart about it. My daughter had the flu about a month ago. I didn't get sick. She was here for a full week. She was sick the whole time. I washed my hands. I sanitized things, sanitary wipes, those alcohol wipes. I wiped things down, I took precautions, told her not to touch certain things. If you need something from the refrigerator, let me get it for you. Common sense things like this will help us not to become sick. If this does become an epidemic, which it seems like it might, stock up on your food and water now, because this and your fuel for your vehicles, because very soon people are going to panic and the stores are going to be wiped out of these things. If you have medication that you take, what I'm about a month ahead of my medication, but that's something that I choose to do. I'm not giving you medical advice. What I do is, if I don't need, I'm diabetic, if I don't need my diabetic medication, if I don't eat certain things, then my blood sugars are fine. So I don't always take my blood sugar medication. I don't always take that stuff. So I have a stockpile of those things. If you can do that, that's something you might want to look into. Like I said, I'm not giving you medical advice, but these are the type of things that are going to be, they're going to have shortcomings of, maybe not diabetic medication, but maybe some other medication that you're on. Food for sure, stock up. I already have a stockpile of food that I have just in case, something happens. And the grocery stores are wiped out. I do have a stockpile of rice, beans, dry goods, noodles, pasta, canned goods, peanut butter, different foods that I already have stockpiled, and rotate those things out. 1 gallon jugs of water, things like this that you can have at on hand in case something happens where you go to the store and the shelves are clear. You have those things in your home and you can ride this out. Many people thought that the next thing that would happen would be the electrical grid, and that's still a possibility. Imagine if the electrical grid goes out now and this turns into an epidemic where it's a pandemic and the country is inundated with sick people, and you don't want to leave your house in fear of getting sick. Well, remember to pray and put on the full armor of God and be wise as a serpent and gentle as a dove and go about your business, but be aware of your surroundings and be aware of how things are spread. Do your research online and be safe. I love you. God loves you. More importantly, read your Bible, pray every day, and put on the full armor of God. Be safe.